as well. First topic today, we're going to talk about Leicester City and Ranieri. Guys, do you think it was fair, or do you think it was even right that he got sacked by Leicester, considering the game he just had in the Champions League?
I believe.
I
believe that he should have been sacked. Maybe the timing was wrong, but how can you go from winning the Premier League to then being 17th? I know everyone goes, oh, but Leicester 17th left. This is where they should be. Doesn't matter what job you're in. If you start by winning the Premier League, you set yourself standards. Yeah. You can't go from first to 17th.
All right, cool. That's a fair point.
I tend to agree.
I agree to an extent, but I want to say that, obviously, there's speculation that he lost the change room. To be fair, that team that is playing right now, there's only one or two players missing right now. Let's say one, Conte, who is a very, very influential player for them and is doing a lot of work for Chelsea right now. He's everywhere. But one player can't dictate a whole team going from winning the Premier League to borderline being relegated right now. So does it make sense that he actually could have lost, you know, that
falls on the manager, because at the end of the day, Leicester last year with almost the same players, like you said, minus Conte, they won the league.
Pearson, when he got sacked, Leicester were in the exact same trouble as they are now. So that's complete bollocks, to be honest with you. Ranieri was better than Pearson. It's the end of story. He won the Premier League.
But wasn't everyone talking about Drinkwater last year? Everyone was talking about Drinkwater being a baller, man. Who is he? He's Drinkwater.
No, but it's the same.
Well, I mean, I'm drinking water, but
it's the same thing with Vardy, though, isn't it? I think that these guys have been fanned out. That's the problem, and he's not motivating them enough. That's the problem.
Who's not league?
Drinkwater.
Vardy.
Well, Vardy should go back to where he came from.
Well, listen. You can't.
That's not non-league. Let's not get a misunderstanding.
Yeah, you can't. But the simple fact is, I know Kante was a big player for Leicester, but you can't go from winning, like even with Mourinho when he was at Chelsea, winning the league to then 10th. It's just unacceptable. The only place it is probably acceptable is Arsenal.
He just got Arsenal right now, man.
No, sorry, but going back to Leicester, yeah, everyone goes, oh, he's a nice guy, he's Mr. Ranieri, blah, blah, blah. We have people, opera singers singing when they win in the league and all that. It doesn't matter. You can't be 17th. Impossible.
The fact of the matter is, Leicester.
I swear they went to 18th yesterday as well.
Yeah. But that's all right. The chances are Leicester would have got relegated with Ranieri, and that would have been a catastrophe financially for them. Let's be real. Leicester are not going to come back from Division 1. Because all their good players are going to go. Mahrez is going to go, Vardy's going to go, Danny Drinkwater's going
to
go.
For me, you had to go, not good enough. Probably lucky he won the Premier League as well. Like, did he buy Kante or did someone else buy the Kante? I don't know. Mahrez was bought by Pearson. Jamie Vardy was Pearson. A lot of it was Pearson. And he doesn't have any credit for it. It's all Ranieri.
So let's say now they get a new manager, which obviously they are. That new manager comes in. Let's say they start playing unreal. Does it make the point valid that the fact that he did lose the dressing room?
It's very, very likely he lost the dressing room, because those teams, those players are not that bad to be 17. There's a lot worse teams than Leicester.
They've all come out yesterday. They came out yesterday. A lot, I think 8 or 9 of them came out and tweeted basically the same time, within an hour of each other, saying, we didn't.
Their
manager told them to do it.
Schmeichel came out, he got interviewed by Sky Sports, and the way he was basically shivering. He was like, oh, I didn't say anything. It wasn't nothing to do with me. Kind of looks like a liar, but that's a whole other subject. But to me, if they do come out, let's say when they get managed this week, next week, whenever it comes, if they start playing well, they start killing teams again like they were last year, it kind of rings alarm.
Do you know what? The only thing I can think is that the Leicester management were kind of hoping for the same effect that Swansea have got. But they've got a new manager, new ideas. The players are going to start playing for him to impress him and so on and so forth.
That's my point. That's what they're hoping for. Ranieri, have we ever seen Claudio Ranieri in a relegation battle? When he's been a Chelsea manager, Roma manager, Monaco manager.
I'm sure he managed Juventus when they were in the sort of the lower leagues in Italy, and he sort of banged. I'm pretty sure it was Ranieri.
Hey, stat guy. Can we get a?
Yeah, has he ever? I'm pretty sure
Ranieri. Has
Ranieri ever been in a relegation dogfight?
No, that's an absolute no. I don't think he has, but I don't think Ranieri is tactically the smartest guy in the world.
If I was
and
the
he changes the team too much, that's the problem.
If I was the board, I'd bring in Nigel Pearson again.
He's not right there. You don't bring back someone you let go of. It's like, well, why would you go back to your ex-girlfriend? You dumped her for a reason. You don't go back. Anyway, point being, Ranieri shouldn't have got sacked. Lawrence is crazy. And I rate that guy. But Pearson, nah, he's gone. If he's gone, he's gone. You don't bring people back. You don't go back to the past. I'm done, bro. You don't bring them guys back.
We know what he did in Thailand.
No, but
we
know what he did there. Under Nigel Pearson, Leicester are never going to be as good as they were under Ranieri. They're just going to be 18th, 20th.
All right.
20th, you know what I mean? They're going to be fine in the relegation. That's what Leicester don't want that. Leicester are trying to be a big club. And rightly so, they won the Premier League last year, so
right
they want
now,
bigger things.
Right
they don't want
now,
to be fine.
They're a small club with a Premier League, which is more than I can say for Arsenal.
No, do you know what? Let's be honest. Now, for what Ranieri achieved last year, he should be having the same kind of. He should be held in the same regard as Wenger, where people say, you know what, he should pick his time to leave. Because they're never ever going to win the Premier League.
I agree with that. There should be sentiment there for that. I think it's very unfair.
And even if he did get relegated, let's be honest, I think they can sort of take that one on the chin simply for what he got them last year.
Right,
but financially,
so yeah,
it would have been a disaster.
Let's get back to it. Do you think it was fair?
For me, they were completely right to sack him. Completely.
What about
right.
the time they sacked him?
The timing could have been. Could they have done it maybe in December? Could they have maybe
January,
done it in December, and then the manager could have come in and brought his own players in January, brought in maybe dogfight.
No, but then maybe they had the hope that he would turn things around.
What do you think?
I think they've done it for the wrong reasons, which I'm sure they've done it for financial reasons. Because, as I said, if they get relegated, they lose a big pot of money.
Yeah.
They lose all their players as well.
I personally think they did it wrong. At the wrong time, shouldn't have been now. If they were going to do it, they should never have sacked him
after the Sevilla result. They should have sacked him maybe after the Swansea game.
Yeah.
And they would have had maybe a better foot to stand on, because they would have said...